time to solve the problem now.
So let's start by drawing a line from A to B. This will aid us as we find the measurements later. And then we'll go to annotation right here. And then we'll go down here. There's this align. This helps us find measurements from A to B. Now we have the distance from A to B. Let's look at the distance from A to the net. As you see, there's nothing to snap on, so we need to go here, back to the snaps, and then push intersection, and this will help us snap onto it. Now we have the measurements. There has been some information provided about the net's height, the ball diameter, and the total of the two, which is around 0.98 meters, this right here. So that's what we're going to do for the net. So let's start plotting. Let's go back to drafting. Here, let's draw a line from A to B. Let's put on our ortho mode first. So from A to B, it is 18.75. We'll correct it to the nearest two decimals. And then, let us draw the net. How tall is the net? 0.98 meters. So we need to move that. So we'll go here and push move. And then we'll move it over. We'll push enter, and then we can move it over by 12.19 meters. There it is. Now let's draw a line that will be the height of the person. Since we don't know the exact, we'll just draw a long line. And then now let's turn off ortho mode. And then let's draw a line from here, this point, to here, and we need to extend it. This is the path the tennis ball follows. So let's push line again. And then here, see, you can't really just snap it on. It's not exactly a straight line. So we need to go here and extend it. And it says here, select objects. This is like the cutting edge. So this is the edge, and then push enter. And then we select the line we want to extend, which is this line. Click it, and then you're done. So now we've plotted this. Let's find the height. The same way, we'll go to annotation. And then we could use linear because it's horizontal and vertical now. Now we have found the height of the player, and the racket has to be 2.8 meters high. This is how you find the answer with AutoCAD.